By close of business, four legislators were added to those who have signed a petition to censure the parliamentary commissioners who are accused of corruption. The solicitors of the signatures, led by Remiega County MP Theodore Sechikobo, Tory Roman Member of Parliament Sarah Opendi, and Kalungu County West MP Joseph Gonzaga Sewungu, say they are left by only one signature to attain the required number.
We are actually left with one signature. She becomes the 176th Member of Parliament to sign this censure motion, and we are actually now preparing.
Among the four legislators who signed the impeachment from yesterday was the chairperson of Lango Parliamentary Group and Kole MP Judith Aliek. Aliek affirmed her commitment to fighting corruption, which is the basis of her conviction to join other legislators fighting for the same cause.
We as members of parliament have been tainted with the word corruption. And for me, as a member of parliament from Lango sub-region, from Kole district, I don't condone corruption.
Masindi Chief Magistrate Kosia Kasibayo yesterday sentenced 8 people to 3 years in prison. These were charged on 3 counts: illegal entry into Makshan Falls National Park, killing of a crocodile and buffalo, and possessing protected species.
Without a doubt, these offenses are rampant within the jurisdiction of this court, and they affect the economy since who is a leading foreign minister to Ghana.
The culprits, who are residents of Masindi and Bulisa, were intercepted by game rangers on July 15th after they were found in possession of wild game meat. Patrick Bishendich, the prosecutor, welcomed the court's judgment. He said the suspects pleaded guilty.
Wildlife Authority, we are happy with the judiciary, because that is a sign that judiciary is also considering wildlife crime seriously, and in a way the courts will also help us in fighting wildlife crime.
A section of education stakeholders in Bukedi sub-region has asked the government to scrap all the art subjects in schools and make agriculture and industrial learning compulsory. They say this will improve the standard of the education. It was raised during a consultative meeting held in Mukuju Co-Primary Teacher Training Center in Toro District. Professor Daud Kavasa, a member of the Education Policy Review Commission, said they're traversing the country to gather views from stakeholders on the education policies to structure an appropriate standard. Professor Kavasa said that they have so far moved to regions like Teso, Acholi, Busoga, Buganda and Karamoja, and they are now in Bukedi.
The summary of the commission is to pick the views of the people countrywide and also those who are outside, and all stakeholders in education, on what is going well, what is not going well, and what needs to be improved and what should be done.
Josephine Kanyi, the Butembo District Education Officer, said there is a mess in the education system to the extent that teachers cannot teach the new lower secondary curriculum. She appealed to the National Curriculum Development Center and the Ministry of Education and Sports to induct teachers across the country.
We have realized that teachers of secondary schools who are implementing the lower secondary curriculum have a very big gap in the implementation part of it. They need a lot of training in this curriculum.
Charles Okomo, the Busia District Inspector of Schools, appealed to the Uganda Communications Commission to close social media platforms that publish unapproved learning resources that are misleading teachers.
The resources which are in the schools, for example, there is a channel that may be learning center, the materials which are there, they are not approved by the regulatory body, which is NCDC. And it is getting into schools. National Curriculum Development Center has not approved these materials, but they are getting into schools. It is UCC that has a mandate to ensure that this does not get into schools.